We're on location in Pandan Bay, the southern Mozambique. Beautiful resort with loads of good fishing and lots of things for us to do. What I've decided to do is show you what I will take to when I'm fishing in a place like this. The most important thing on your kayak is, number one, you need to be organized. The more organized you are, definitely the more fish you're going to catch. On deciding what you're going to take fishing, you need to sit down and make a few decisions of what type of fishing you're going to be doing. It's not necessary to take the whole kitchen sink if you're doing a very basic type of fishing, you know, if you're going to go and target Natal snook or even just target king mackerel or kuta. So the first thing to remember is decide on what type of fishing you're doing. Once you've decided on that type of fishing, put the necessary tackle aside, and that's the tackle you need to pack and take with you. The difficult scenario we have here is we're fishing in Pandan, Mozambique. Here we have lots of big drop-offs, awesome pinnacles to fish on. One minute we can be targeting kuta and trawling around, the next minute we can see the showings of the fish finder, or the kingfish on the fish finder, and then we want to drop shot and rig. So this type of fishing forces you to be a lot more organized. It forces you to take everything with you, and this is where packing correctly and organizing your tackle is very, very important. The first two items that I check and make sure they're ready to go when I'm fishing are, number one, my handheld GPS. With this, like this Garmin e-trex handheld, I can now pinpoint all the positions I want to go and fish at. I can take my marks and paddle out to my marks and look around and see what I'm going to be targeting. The next thing after I've used my GPS is to use my fish finder correctly. I'll then use my fish finder to watch it, look for the showings, look for the movement, look for what sort of fish maybe are on the finder, and then fish accordingly. The next thing we move on to are the rods and reels. Fishing in a place like this, there's some serious fish around. I tend to tackle up and make sure that I'm fishing with good quality rods and good quality reels. You'll find the Shimano and the Daiwa rods and reels. Those are the ones we tend to use a lot in the kayaks. We've tested them, they can take the knocks, you know, they can take the salt and the seawater that we expose them to. At an event like this, I generally will take 4 or 5 rods with me. One rod that I have with me is a drop shot or jigging rod. In this case, I will put a little drop shot on, or I'll put a squid jig on, or I'll put a little pencil jig, and I'll fish this when I'm fishing the deeper water and I'm jigging and drop shotting. The reason why I say 4 or 5 rods is you have two options. One, you can take a rod like this, which you can use for throwing or casting spoons and for drop shotting. Or you can take another outfit exactly like this with a decent reel, where you attach a spoon and then you're going to throw at the live bonnies, or you're going to throw at the live bait and try and catch the live bait. So this rod, you can use 1 or 2 for the purpose. The advantage of using 2, of course, is if you're drop shotting and the game fish come up, you have your rod that you can throw a spoon, you can target the fish straight away. However, if you're busy with this rod to change over a spoon, often you will miss the fish. The next two rods that I have are my trawling rods. These rods and reels are basically kitted out to trawl, whether it be a dead bait or trawl a daisy chain like on this rod, or to pull a holco or to pull a rapala. These rods are our trawling rods. We take 2 of them with us and we interchange the lures or the baits or the tactics with these specific rods for quite a lot of our fishing. So it's important, and with these two rods, once again, you have a quality rod and reel. If you have a quality rod and reel, you're going to get quality results. Okay, so that gives us 3 or 4 rods already. The reason why I say 3 or 4, as I mentioned before, your spinning rod, you have 2 options. You can take 1 or 2. So we have 2 trawling rods that we can interchange, and 1 drop shot jigging your spinning rod. Then the X Factor rod. X Factor, the rod that I say, often a rod that you'll take many, many times and never use it. But it is very, very important to have. In my case, this rod is sort of slightly bigger, slightly better reel, shorter, stronger rod. And I rig this for live bait only. With some of the live bait that we're catching, we've generally got, let's say, 10 or 15 seconds to rig the live bait correctly. Otherwise, you'll die before you can swim them. So if you're wasting your time and changing your traces and trying to tie in a live bait trace and take off a rapala off the other rod, by the time you've done that, your live bait's probably died. You spend half an hour trying to catch your live bait, catch it, and it dies on you in 10 seconds. So take a rod like this, whether it be similar to your other trawling rod or even an upgrade like this one I have with me, make sure it's ready to pin the bait. If you're ready, I'm sure you're going to get a good result.